Hi there, I'm Mike Frank, the instructor for Psych 60, Intro to Developmental Psych. In this video, I want to tell you about the development of children's ability to use language to express complex ideas with a specific focus on syntax. Every language has tons of words in it, but the language itself is more than just words. Even if you memorized every definition in the dictionary, you still wouldn't know how to put words together to make coherent sentences. You'd just end up with word salad. Syntax, or grammar, is a name for the rules that govern how words are put together into sentences. So if you want to say that John ate two cookies, syntax tells us how to put these together. A key part of this is that each word has a different syntactic category, or part of speech. For example, John is a noun, ate is a verb, two is what we call a determiner, and cookies is a noun. Syntax tells us how these categories can combine to form larger categories, like noun phrase or verb phrase. And it also tells us how these larger categories combine with each other to make whole sentences. This tree diagram I've drawn shows one view of the underlying syntactic structure of the sentence. And if that structure were different, we'd get a different meaning out. John ate two cookies is very different than two cookies ate John, and two ate cookies John isn't a sentence at all. How do we know that language has these syntactic rules? Maybe we just use the meanings underlying sentences to understand if they are grammatical. Noam Chomsky, one of the founding fathers of linguistics, gave a set of examples that show that we can differentiate syntactic structure, grammar, from semantics, or the meaning of a sentence. Chomsky said, "Colorless green ideas sleep furiously." You've probably never heard this sentence before, and no individual pair of words in the sentence makes any sense. Something that's colorless can't be green, ideas can't be green, ideas don't know how to sleep, and you can't really sleep furiously. But we still know this is an English sentence, even without knowing the meaning. And of course, if you've heard that sentence before, because now it's a famous linguistic example, we can make up a new one, like unsaturated beige notions doze hideously, and so on. So syntax and semantics, meaning and grammar, are two different things. So how do children learn to combine words together? This is the amazing part. While children don't immediately speak in complete sentences, it's only a matter of months or at most a year or two between when they start speaking at all and when they're combining words together in syntactically correct ways. As usual, Dinosaur Comics says it best. T-Rex says, "You can take a baby, put it down in a room full of complete strangers making crazy noises, and that baby will do the following. Presuppose those noises have meaning, independently invent the very idea of language, and then learn to communicate in that language. They will stone cold deduce rules of grammar from observation alone, and they'll do it way faster than an adult ever could." Syntactic development is very fast. Here are some examples from my daughter, Madeline. At 18 months, she was only saying single words like doggy, but her sentences quickly got longer. At 20 months, she said, "Move back." At 22 months, "Mama, read me book." At 24 months, "No, do that again." And at 26 months, she was saying things like, "My other friend named Caleb." The mechanisms underlying children's syntactic development are one of the biggest mysteries in psychology and linguistics. Researchers are still trying to figure out how much of the structure of language is innately known by children and how much is learned from experience. But there are a couple of things we can say for certain. First, children learn by observation and conversation, not by explicit teaching. By and large, when parents talk to kids, they're much more interested in communicating than about whether their kids are making subtle grammatical errors. Although English teachers and some parents will correct you if you say, "You and me went to the store" instead of "you and I," or "I ain't going" instead of "I'm not going," parents never say to their children, "The verb phrase goes before the noun phrase." Second, children make some pretty interesting errors early on, suggesting that they are actively making generalizations about how language works, and sometimes these aren't quite right. For example, they make pronoun or agreement errors like "my want it." They use negation in ways that are different than the ways that adults use it. "That no my sippy." And they make errors in morphology. The endings on words that tell us about how many things there are, what tense a verb is in, and so forth. Like "bunny go to the forest." In each of these cases, the error shows that the child is trying to figure out the right rule and has, sometimes briefly, settled on an intermediate rule that works some of the time. For example, if we were going to talk about bunny walking, then walked would be right. But for going, we can't say goed, we have to say went. Third, children know a lot more than they can say, and they can often interpret syntactic structures that they aren't yet able to produce. A strong test of this idea comes from experiments where you test whether children are able to use the order of words to figure out who did what to whom. For example, if you say, "Bunny is gorping duck," and kids have never heard the word gorp before, even before their second birthday, they still look more at pictures where Bunny is doing something to duck, rather than pictures where duck is doing something to Bunny. So this means they've already generalized that the first noun, Bunny, is the one who's performing the action, whatever that action may be. All right, to wrap up, syntax refers to the underlying grammatical rules that govern how words go together to make sentence. And syntax can be distinguished from semantics, the underlying meaning. When we think about children's learning of syntax, there's still a lot of mysteries out there. Nevertheless, we know that children learn syntactic structure very rapidly, and they learn not by explicit teaching, but through conversation with their parents and by generalizing from the language they hear. Thanks very much for watching.